guys.
The box.
Oh, the box of blocks. Hey guys. Equipment today, we are doing lower body. So we're doing thrusters, squats, deadlift, dumbbell swing. But for our core circuit, you're going to need a block or like a yoga block or a small ball or even a pillow you can use. But something harder would be more beneficial. And then sliders, if you have them. And a step. Warmed up, we'll be warming up until about 8:35. We'll do some mobility, and then we'll get into our workout. Thank you. Okay, a couple more minutes, getting warm back. Everybody has their weights. If you're just getting on virtually, weights for lower body, we're doing squats, thrusters, deadlift, and dumbbell swing. For our core circuit, some sliders and a block if you have it. You can also use a pillow or a small ball if you don't have those. If you don't have sliders, socks on a wood floor works. Or paper plates also works. Thank you. want you to take your hand off of the monkey leg, place it on the ground, rotate around, looking up towards the ceiling, stretching those fingers up. Then rotate around, bring the hand onto the inside of your knee now. Rotate the other way. Again, stretch those fingers up towards the ceiling. And then come forward again. Your arms on the head or on the hips. Nice. Bring those arms down. Let's switch legs. Bring the arms up, pulsing forward. There's some little tap shoes. Are you looking for?
Yeah, my daughter looks for like that.
Yeah. Or it could be downstairs in the
okay.
In the lost and found. Hand down, opposite the leg you need. Rotate around. Bring the hand on the inside of your knee. You stretch those fingers up. Okay, let's come forward again. Pulsing. Okay, hands down on the ground, feet behind you. Press up into downward dog. And then slowly walk the hands in. Make sure your shoes are tied. Slowly come up, shoulder circles to the back, opening up the chest, and then shoulder circles forward, and then arms out, small circles, progressively getting bigger, moving through all parts of our body, get everything warmed up, movement, going backwards, circles, progressively getting smaller, and then we're swinging the arms front to back, opening up the chest, and then give yourself a big hug, and then rotating from the hips, keeping that back nice and flat. Okay, let's talk about our workout today. Make it somewhat Valentine's themed. Okay, so for our first exercise, we're gonna use the sliders. They're gonna be on our hands. And we're gonna make hearts with the sliders. So sliding out in a heart shape. Bring it back. We're a circle, but whatever. So slide out, slide out. If you want to modify it and just do a plank, that's fine. That's cool. Then we're doing core pulls. You're going to be on your mat, grabbing that block. So we've done core pulls before. This time we're going to press our knees into the block while we're pulsing. If you want to drop the heels down onto the ground, that's fine. If you want to make it a little bit harder, pull those legs up. You can do a combination of the three. That's totally fine. Okay, you're going to keep that block between your knees. Bend the knees, 90 degrees. Where are the blocks? In the box. Okay, so block is the knees. end of the mat. Heels are pressing into the sliders. And we're gonna press out and pull it in. If you wanna make it harder, both legs at the same time, press out, pull it in. You guys are gonna do great. You're doing three times through, 40 seconds on, 20 seconds off. If you need to adjust and take a little break within that interval, totally fine. Make it work for you. Okay, here we go. Plank parts. The planks are, hold on, let me get my timer. Ready? And let's go. Circle it out, bring it back. Nice. Try to keep those hips level. Nice work, guys. Squeezing those glutes. A nice wide placement with your feet helps with stability. Five, four, three, two, and one. You. Okay. On to our mats. You've got the core pulse with your block between the knees. One in about 10 seconds. Okay, pull those shoulders down and back. Brace the core. Knees are bent. Pulse in the arm, shoulders back. If you find your shoulders running forward, just drop those heels down to the ground. That's right. Woo! Nice job. Pressing into that block. You got this. Pull those shoulders back. It's great if you need to. Okay. Let's go. Five, four, three, two, one. Nice. Okay. We are going into our side plank with that block. If you want to hold weight overhead, you can. You don't have to. Let's start getting into position. So, elbow underneath the shoulder. Knees are bent 90 degrees. That bottom leg is staying on the ground. The hip comes up, but the calf stays on the ground. Ready? Let's go. Looking out, not down. So shoulders square. Nice, guys. Press into that block. And we're switching. Give you time to get into position. You don't feel like you have to rush it. In the position, here we go. Let's go. Keep those legs bent. The hip is coming off the ground, but your knee and calf are staying on the ground. And you're done. Nice job. Okay, hamstring walk out. Create the block with the sliders. Pressing into your sliders, all the way, your scoots down all the way to the end of your mat. Heels start close to your butt, press out, pull it back in. Doing one at a time is a little bit easier. And your hips are off the ground, you're in a glute bridge. Nice work. Okay. One time through. Four to go. Pump up. Nice. Go to the top. Yes. Go. Straight those legs. Or put the heels down. Either one. Yeah. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's a hard one. And I took it up a notch. With the block. What do you think? I like the block, adding the block. Okay. We have our side plank with the block. Okay, let's get into position. Knees are bent about 90 degrees. Ready? Let's go. Press up. Out. Pressing both knees into the block. Working the obliques, adding that block. We're also working the adductors. Good. Two sides. Ready? And go. Press it up. Press into that block. Looking strong. Looking strong. We have 3 more seconds on the and one. Switch it up.
Letting gravity pull them down. So my lats are engaged the entire time. So hinging and standing up. And then you're gonna get rid of one of your weights for the final movement, holding it by the top. Again, shoulders down and back, hinging. This time we're swinging to shoulder height. So same movement, but we're using a little power. So we've got two power moves, bookending our squat and deadlift. Good. Yeah, let's do it.
Thank you. pause. Up, one, two. Down for count of one, two. Up for count of one, two. Down. Up. Nice. Push your feet through the ground. Keep those shoulders down. And more seconds. Five, four, three, two, and one. Woo! How you guys doing? Good? Okay, we have our deadlift. We're going in 10 seconds, so catch your breath. Okay, we're gonna get into position. So grab those weights, shoulders down and back. Rotate them out in front of your legs. And here we go. Hinging forward, skimming those weights along your legs. Press the ground away. Butt is going back, different than the squat, but it's going down. Excellent. You're going to be feeling this in the hamstrings and glutes. Even the lats a little bit by keeping them locked down into place. Three, two, and one. Nice job. Shake it out. Okay. Got our dumbbell swing. 7 seconds. Let's grab that weight. Good. Shoulders down and back. Lock them in place. Ready, let's go. Swing. Hands and swing. Your feet can be nice and wide. You feel like you're kind of pressing those knees out. Widen your stance just a little bit. Nice. Increase in that heart rate. Okay, we are back to thrusters. 7 seconds. Grab some water if you need to. Okay, into position. Ready, let's go. Half squat down, powered up. Okay. Halfway through. Keep those wrists stiff. Press up. Five, four, three, two, one. Nice work. Woo. Okay. Squats. So 15 seconds. Okay, you guys ready? Okay, let's get going. Get those weights. Down for count of one, two. Up for count of one, two. Down for count of one, two. Up for count of one, two. Down. Up. Down. Up. Good, you're done. Nice job. Okay, deadlifts. One in 10 seconds. Okay, let's grab those weights. Shoulders down and back. Lock them down. Here we go.
extending those weights along the legs. Press up. Your knees are staying soft. You don't have to lock them out. We've got 10 more seconds. And there you go. Okay. We have a dumbbell swing. Lock in the plate.
Heck yeah, let's go. Looks good. Five, four, three, two, one. Awesome.
Boom.
Talk about the last round. Okay, so this is where it gets fun. So, changing up the interval, we're not using any weights. High intensity, short interval, 20 seconds on, 10 seconds rest. And we're going hard, keeping that heart rate up. We'll be done in 10 minutes. So, first one, side step, up, and over. You can add a little hop at the top if you want, or you can just step up. But I want you swinging those arms at the top as you step down. Does everybody feel comfortable stepping up on their step? Okay. I know it feels a little awkward and you want to look down. Maybe the first one, look down, get a sense of where your body is in space. But after that, try to look out. You can see that bench from your peripheral vision and your center of gravity is much better when you're looking out, not down. So good practice for balance and stability. Then you can use one of your weights. You can use your step, but we're doing toe tap. So you're pulling your knee up, tapping your toe up. You don't have to hop. One foot on the ground, tapping that toe up. You can even march in place. Either one's fine. Then number three, we're kicking our own butts. I have to use that joke every time. So, keeping that torso nice and tall, pulling the heels up towards the butt, kicking your butt. Again, you don't have to hop. You can stand in one place. Again, keeping that torso up, pulling the heel up as close as you can to the butt. Now we're finishing off with satyrs, so lateral movements. Right, planting one foot, hinging from the hips, driving the other foot back. So you're like a speed satyr. So you can do it without the hop, or always have one foot up in the air. And you're hinging, you're reaching with the opposite arm towards that leg. 5 times through, 20 on, 10 off. It's fun. It's fun when it's done. I promise you'll feel amazing. Okay, we got our side step up and over. Everyone ready? Let's go. Again, you don't have to hop. That doesn't feel comfortable. Okay, keep it up. Okay, you are done with that. Okay, we have our toe taps. Either with your weight on your bench or just marching in place. Ready and go! Our skaters.
No one take the weights off because we're going to decide to step up and go low.
Okay, we have skaters starting now. So, driving the nine anchor leg behind, over your midline, behind you. Yeah. Five, four, three, two, one.
Boom. One down, four to go.
Okay. Side step up and over. Let's do it. You're done. Okay, into toe taps in 5 seconds. Ready? Let's go. Love it, love it, love it. Five, four, three, two, one. The kicks. Ready? Let's go. Thank you. looking good. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo! Is it good? Hey.
Butt kicks.
Ready, let's go. Okay, I want you to stand up, grab your foot behind you, stretching the quad out. Thank you. chest. Rotate from the hips. Hey, nice work, guys. Here's some rags in the back. You want to spray it and spray up or wipe down your equipment before you put it out there.
Thank you.
Wednesday.
Okay.
But I'll be here, but there is a sub.
Okay. I'll see what time.